Hello, this is Dr. Grande. Today's question is, can I analyze the GameStop Wall Street controversy? Just a reminder, I'm not diagnosing anybody in this video, only speculating about what could be happening in a situation like this. If you enjoyed this video, please like it, subscribe to my channel, and consider supporting me on Patreon. I'll put the link to Patreon in the description for this video. So I'll start off by describing GameStop. It is important to note here that there are actually several companies tied up in this controversy, including American Airlines, Bed Bath & Beyond, and AMC, but I'm going to focus on GameStop. GameStop is a brick-and-mortar retailer based in Grapevine, Texas. They operate more than 5,000 stores that sell video games. The market for these products is massive. The video game industry has benefited from advances in technology, with games becoming increasingly sophisticated and realistic. Even with the strength of the industry, GameStop has faced a lot of competition from places like Amazon, online retailers, and has been underperforming for a long time. They did implement several tactics that helped them, but it was really not enough. Now, GameStop is a publicly traded company, and there's this prediction that they would not do well financially. Many investors started shorting the stock of the company. I'll describe what it means to short sell. This is also referred to as shorting a stock or just shorting. First, let me describe what investors do normally if they're interested in buying and selling stocks. This is called long investing. I'll use this example of 10 shares that are worth $5 each. An investor buys those 10 shares for $50 total. The share price goes up to $20. Now, this is per share. So now they own $200 worth of shares. They sell them and they make $150. Pretty straightforward. This is a common strategy and it's dependent on those shares increasing in value. So the question becomes, can investors make money if they accurately predict shares will lose value? Well, the answer is yes. And that brings us to the idea of short selling. What happens with shorting is an investor borrows shares and then immediately sells them. Their hope is they can buy them back at a lower price, return them to the lender, and keep the difference. Using the example of 10 shares going for $5 each, the investor borrows the shares and sells them at that price, $50 for all 10. If the stock price drops to $1, the investor can buy all 10 shares back for $10. Therefore, they make $4 for each share. That would be $40 profit. I'm simplifying this a bit because there are other fees involved, but that's basically how it works. Why do many stock market experts believe that short selling is not as good as long investing? Well, it's really about how much you can lose. In the first example, the most you could lose is $50. The company goes out of business, the shares are worthless, but you can't lose more than you paid. The maximum loss is 100%. With short selling, the sky is the limit as far as losses. If they buy a share for $5 and the value goes up to $100, they lose $95 per share. If the value increases to $500, they lose $495. So now moving back to what happened with GameStop. A discussion was started on a Reddit forum called r/WallStreetBets. This forum is focused on stock trading tips. The discussion brought up the idea of buying GameStop stock and driving up the share price. There were a few reasons for this. If they drove up the price, eventually, in theory, they could sell it for more money, although not everybody would get more money. Those who sold first would make money, and those who sold late would lose money. I think part of it was an affection for what GameStop represents. It's a brick-and-mortar retailer. There's a lot of nostalgia around GameStop for a lot of people. And, of course, there's this reason to devastate the Wall Street traders who took a short position on that stock, people who thought it would be a good idea to bet against GameStop. If these investors drove up the price, those Wall Street traders would lose money. People on Reddit came together and started buying the stock. The stock price was around $18 at the beginning of 2021. Within 3 weeks, it was trading at $347 a share. The price increased dramatically because they bought the stock and because of a feedback loop that occurs when a stock is heavily shorted. The investors who had short positions have to buy back the stock to prevent even more drastic losses. When they buy back the stock, that increases the share price as well. It's this vicious cycle. The effect has been devastating to those investors who were shorting the stock. 71 million shares were shorted at the time the drastic increase occurred. Those short sellers have lost over $6 billion at the time of making this video. This has caused a bit of a ripple effect. Many of these short sellers had to sell other stocks to raise money to cover their short positions. Now, some trading companies have restricted activity on GameStop. One of these companies, Robinhood, made it so people could sell the stock but not buy it. Many people believe that these trading companies are doing this to protect large Wall Street investors. So was this a good idea? Were these people on Reddit, these mostly new and inexperienced investors, really geniuses? Did they figure out how to make money and punish the elite? I suppose the answers to these questions would be no and yes. I will explain. So with the first question, all of this buying of shares is well and good, but it doesn't actually change anything about GameStop. It doesn't give them some secret technology, some special way to earn enough profit to justify the new valuation. Market experts predict that these shares will come down to around $15 in the near future. It is likely that all of these new investors are going to take massive losses. It actually gets into a bit of a game involving psychology. On Reddit, these novice investors are pushing each other to continue to buy the stock and hold it. Eventually, a number of people are going to look at how the stock has increased from what they paid, and they're going to sell. Why not make the money? Why not sell now instead of risking taking a loss later? When this happens, it can create a cascade effect. Everybody's going to be running to the door at the same time. The price is going to plummet. The novice investors might think of themselves as above this type of behavior, but they're not. It's human nature. Nobody wants to be the one without a chair when the music stops. So what about the second question, punishing the elite? Well, the answer is yes. I think they did accomplish that. $6 billion is a substantial sum. In addition to the losses, the Wall Street investors were shocked. Some view this as an example of how a little guy can get a good shot in at a big corporation. I guess another question would be, was it worth what will almost certainly be massive losses by the small investors to strike out against the Wall Street investors? Perhaps this is more of a Pyrrhic victory. The behavior of the small investors seems to fall under what is referred to as the mob mentality or the herd mentality. They're taking risks based on emotion. They're looking at other people who made the same decision and feeling pressure to go along with the crowd. This has been responsible for a number of economic bubbles and market crashes over the years. There may be a larger issue behind this, though, in terms of who gets victimized in this situation. Online trading has become easier and cheaper and has drawn a lot of new investors into the market. In a sense, these different apps have turned investing into a video game, sending notifications which appear to draw users toward risky investments. Many of them have lost a great deal of money. Part of the problem is these investors don't understand the market. If we compare the customers of Robinhood to those of a place like Charles Schwab, we see that Robinhood users trade 40 times as many shares as Charles Schwab customers and 88 times as many risky options contracts. It's like they're just pressing buttons on their phone and not realizing that there are financial consequences. Now, some people have said that, yes, there are a number of uninformed investors who are taking massive losses because of apps like Robinhood, but it's also getting them involved in the market. They're breaking into a world that has been out of reach. I suppose allowing somebody who only moments ago learned to ride a tricycle to fly a 747 would be giving them something that was out of reach, opening them up to a whole new world of crashing and exploding. Every industry has nuances. Every industry has a learning curve. Investing is more than just pressing a button labeled trade on some app. Often government regulation is there to simply slow things down, which is not always a bad idea. Perhaps those investors need to take a more measured approach. Research has repeatedly shown that when small investors make frequent trades, they tend to lose money. These investors might look at the larger hedge funds and think, I want to do what they do. I need to be trading every second. But the hedge funds have a lot more expertise. I like the idea that there are no barriers to entering the world of trading. Everybody should be allowed to trade stocks easily. But I don't think that banding together to drive up prices for particular stocks is a good idea. The idea behind the stock market is that companies are valued in some realistic way. It makes no sense that GameStop would go from being worth about $2 billion to over $20 billion in the course of a few months. They haven't done anything to earn that value. It seems like a situation that's going to come crashing down. I think it would make more sense to study the market and try to make intelligent trades. Those are my thoughts on the GameStop controversy. Please put any opinions and thoughts in the comments section. They always generate an interesting dialogue. As always, I hope you found my analysis of this topic to be interesting. Thanks for watching.